We're back, bitches!
Yes, we really are persistent and efficient, aren't we?
Yes, because I tend to do longer recording sessions than the usual. Sprout Tower! Gee, I guess what these guys are using.
You guess who we and we have a daddy as our starter.
Yeah. Should I make the joke because it says Nico?
Yes.
Nico, Nico, Nico!
Nico, let's go bowling!
No, we are thinking of two completely different franchises here. I'm thinking Love Live, you're thinking something else entirely. Oh, Jesus Christ. Yup. Jesus Christ, not even better. Let's go Electro Bowling, it uses explosion. Yeah, you know what a screwed up thing is?
Hey, you're gonna
strike every time. No, 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 you know what the screwed up thing is? Togepi used Metronome. Togepi used Explosion. The whole fucking stadium fainted. Okay. Oh shit, I forgot these things have Vine Whip. Oh shit, I just realized Bambi's a tank. I would not know, because I have not played Bayonetta yet.
In Bayonetta 2, I used the word weapons.
But no, seriously, Phanpy is a fucking tank.
But is he more of a tank than Chunky Boy?
Yes, the only downside, and here's the thing, it can actually tank its weakness pretty well at this point. Well, then again, these guys are level 3. So, that would explain it. No, you were thinking something else entirely. I was going for Love Live memes, but it worked anyway.
I don't know what that even comes from. I just know it's a meme that people hate.
I forgot I had Hoppip in the front, but it's just a rat, so I'm just gonna run. Don't really care.
It's a ratty rat. You kept when you should
get Ratatouille. Oh my god! I would call you out to the police, but I wouldn't want to rat you out now, would I? No, I was just going along with it. Oh, that's just a cheesy movie, but it's really good. That was my accident, I swear to God. Jesus Christ, why do I always come up with the puns by complete accident and they end up being funny as hell? No, no, I'll do you one better. I'll do you one better, actually. How, why the hell is Gordo's 2B a low anti-air on frame 9? Well, the second hit goes top of the screen. But that's beside the point.
I'd say slow it down or reduce it, right?
No, slow it down would be the secondary option. The primary option would be make the first hit a fucking mid. Because that does not look like a low, just saying. We're just talking random Blaze Blue level shit, but that's beside the point. Yes, it was his old 2C and Undernight, but still. How a game is balanced from their home series should not affect how it's balanced in a crossover.
Very true. But, by that logic, Rachel would be a very high tier.
If we were going by that logic, Rachel would actually still be top 10, but she's barely top 15 as of now, at least in my opinion. No, Iron God would be the one to do that if he still played Rachel.
No, I just make her feel like a meme. Oh, wait.
She's just basically the meme board. Rachel is basically a meme board. And if you're wondering who we're referring to, it's Rachel fucking Alucard. Whom is, if I may allow you to carry this one, Hazama? Again, if you're wondering who we were referring to, it's Rachel fucking Alucard. And if you're wondering who she is, well, that's your cue. No, no, you were supposed to make a Helsing Ultimate Abridged reference. Not a mandatory trainer, but I'd fight this fucker anyway. Basically, once we get to the top, I'm gonna refresh just so we can do the rest of it all in one go before heading into the gym. Can you hold on a second? I will be right back. There we go. Okay, is this coming in better?
Much better.
Yeah, Discord's just being Discord, but what else is new? It's probably because my input volume is so low, just to prevent ear rape. Because, yeah, you wouldn't want to be hearing my input volume at 100% when I ran into that shiny Hoppip.
Oh, my God.
Oh, trust me, that's going to be a highlight for sure. And it was just one... I only had one Pokeball. So, I beat Chugga Conroy in one respect. Not only did I find a shiny faster than he did, but I got it in one Pokeball as opposed to two.
No, if you do a Gen 4 playthrough...
I have no way to record DS footage, and emulators are a little... DS emulators are slow for me on these things. And, well, Desmume seems to hate Pokemon, let's just say that. So I don't know how I'd be able to actually do that sort of thing.
And if you ever do, that's pretty much my favorite region.
Honestly, I still consider Unova in Black and White 2 my favorite region. That's beside the point.
I say Unova
had the best story. Good timing to actually learn a flying type move. No, that's later generations. I'm referring to Hoot Hoot. I don't give a hoot hoot about what you're doing, just don't get in my way. And one quick quick turn, and I am actually going to refresh real quick. And you just said that right as I started recording. And you know what's actually funny? It's Sage Jin right now. That's actually kind of funny. Oh, this might hurt. This might hurt a lot. Yeah. That did a good chunk of damage. Critical at the perfect time. Please tell me I don't get hit with one in return. Awesome. Yes. Two criticals back to back. Okay, let me go ahead and use a couple of potions. I've got 9 of these things, may as well. God damn it. We just finished up with Sage Jin, and you go and make another Blaze Blue joke.
That should not have hit, but whatever.
You mean how BB Tag is in general? No, you know what we need to do? We need to get into a room match and just everyone play Tager. Because no, Tager mirrors are so janky!
I like my jank to make sense.
No, here's the thing. Tager matches are janky for the stupid reasons. Oh, shiny Hoppip. That's basically what he's gonna be calling him for now until we get to the name, Raider. No, but you wanna know the stupid thing is? So slow down plus input delay equaling shitty connection as a result.
Yes.
Then again, any sort of input delay can piss off as far as I'm concerned. Oh, you know what the best part is about this? Hoppip quad resists Vine Whip. Probably doesn't know about the whole MTU thing. Let me see here. No, there was one guy, I literally had to call out his connection because it was literally unbearable. Let me tell you something here. Speaking of lag, is it just me or do Undernight characters specifically have a lot of input delay on some of their moves even in a perfect connection? Like, tell me, try doing a high JC to JC online and tell me that's not fucking different. Online? All I have to say is, tell me that doesn't feel different offline compared to online. You should do it for- you should do Merkaba Rachel for Halloween. Which is in a couple of days as of recording. Not that I give a damn mind you anymore, but... I'll probably still try to play Rachel for a little bit.
You don't need to try to play Rachel. Or Rachel is actually good. But look at this person's Narukami Gordo. This is actually tough.
Is it Azure Jose?
It's not Leo. If this is actually pathetic.
Oh, Narukami Gord, yeah, in other words, basically just going for top tiers.
And I almost perfected them. They got one hit on me the entire match, and that was it. And they died to a below belly of snipe. The only thing
that
was Rachel.
No, the main trick shot with Rachel. We're talking Blaze Blue stuff in the middle of a Pokémon LP. What the shit?
I mean, I was talking to Red. We were talking Yu-Gi-Oh in the middle of a Pokémon playthrough.
True. I mean, not that a lot of people are gonna... There are gonna be a few people who probably don't know what I'm talking about, but still. Re-escape rope, which we'll be using after this match. There are some people who probably don't keep up with Yu-Gi-Oh, and I don't blame them. Well, Blaze Blue has only recently gained popularity, but that's mainly due to Ruby getting into BB Tag. Which, I'm gonna say this right now, just to kind of get this out there. I really feel like... The worst part about Ruby's inclusion in BB Tag is the fucking fanbase. Not gonna mention any names, that's more of an inside thing that we'd rather not talk about, but... Still, the Ruby fanbase is just straight up toxic. Are you there? Because I'm pretty sure you should be coming in. Ah. And by pressure, you mean, is this neutral? Dear God.
I mean, it's not helping
them. And now Lucario's caught in the coils. Your dad is
definitely like cocaine. And they
tried to EX
Grim Reaper, but he got rid of them in the goddamn face.
Tiny Lebellium. Or that too. No, you haven't put between a chain and a hard place. I guess you could say that was an awkward chain of events.
You know what is genuinely cocaine for me in this game?
Getting raw eternal coils from residents. No, 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 I'll give you the ultimate cocaine for a Hosma player. 2C leg day, 2C leg day, 2C leg day, 2C coils.
No, that's just like candy, that's just, like, you'll never need to do that.
It's just sort of there. And I've only got about 55 seconds left on recording time, so... True enough. Oh, that's gonna hurt. Critical hit, super effective. Okay, going to have to refresh the recording for a second. About fucking time. One massive grind later. Yeah. Could you move it along the whole lot of time cards? But yes, this is our first gym, and compared to the Pewter City gym, this is about as easy. We're just dealing with a bunch of birds. That's basically all it is. Yeah, and in the Liquid Crystal ROM hack, they actually made him a fucking threat. It made the entire game pretty challenging, actually. Okay, and the only other trainer here. He doesn't really... Unpopular opinion, but he doesn't really care for Dragon Ball in general, but that's just how he is, just like... Let's not go there, because I know that there are probably going to be some Dragon Ball fans in the comments who will get really pissy. I'd rather not start a flame war, let's be real. I'd rather try to keep things at least somewhat peaceful here. How much do you want to bet they press the YOLO button and a lot of JBs? With Mai in particular. Well, JBs in general, actually, I forgot. Who do I want to go with? No, let's just go with just Cyndaquil. Well, it won't be Cyndaquil for much longer because we are at the required level. You know what it's time for. No, something special to happen. T-minus 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, time to evolve. And we now have Quilava. Let me go ahead and move back over here to heal.
Oh shit, that killed my Rachel.
Well, that came out of nowhere. Anyway, I am going to refresh for a second, and I will... Actually, I'll refresh once I get to where Falkner is. Alright, going to refresh the recording. And it's gym leader time, let's go. So, what do you have to say about Falkner in particular?
The
all I have to say is, it's Storm Eagle! I doubt any one of you guys is gonna get that reference. Wow, someone actually got that! Anyway, level 7 Pidgey, level 9 Pidgeotto. I'm pretty sure he got that Pidgeotto in Pokemon Yellow's Viridian Forest. Ouch! He probably got that Pidgeotto in Pokemon Yellow's Viridian Forest. He's probably going to get off his signature attack at least once. No, he's not. He's not going for Mud Slap. This could be it right here. Overleveled a little, yes, but who cares? And for our first badge, it is going to be the Zephyr badge. With this, we get Mud Slap, which for a while is pretty decent, but there are better ground type moves. But for early game, it's actually pretty good. True enough. Oh yes, indeed. Actually, let me go to my TM selection. And give Mud Slap to our boy Fanfi. Well, girl in this case.
Oh my
god! Pokemon Sun and Moon, if anyone doesn't know. But there is one last thing we are going to do before we cut this off. At least for this session. You just have to go to the Pokemon Center for a second. And we have a Pokemon Egg! There is actually something we can do with this, and I'll be right back once it actually hatches. And more grinding later for no reason.
More grinding.
We have a Togepi! Honestly, I don't care for Togepi until Gen 4. Because here's the thing, Togepi doesn't only evolves into Togetic in Gen 2. Come Gen 4, when it gained the evolution Togekiss, oh boy. Honestly, it became amazing given it could learn Aura Sphere, I think Thunderbolt, and Psychic. Oh right, I forgot it could also learn Air Slash. And we get the Everstone. Basically, this is a whole item where if a Pokemon's holding it, it won't evolve.
Oh, sorry. And Air Slash.
But real quick to talk about the Everstone, because that's also involved in a glitch with Kadabra. Oh right, I forgot about that. But you can discuss that when we get to the daycare, because I have no knowledge of that shit. But in the meantime, I'm just gonna run all the way back to freaking Violet City, and I'll be right back. And finally we're back here, with everyone being quite overleveled. But to talk about the Everstone glitch for a second, you know how when you trade, Kadabra evolves to Alakazam? Oh, right, I think I talked about that before, but it is on purpose, where the Everstone is supposed to stop trade evolutions from happening, but it only fails to do so with Kadabra. And I'm pretty sure that's on purpose with the whole lawsuit thing that I talked about beforehand in my Gen 1 LP, but that's beside the point. You'd think they'd be... Oh, the hunter that has an Everstone! I know the one you're talking about, because I did that trade!
Is it...
But, let us deposit that Togepi, because we will not be needing that.
It's just like, why would you do this?
That's pretty much what it is, yeah. But we are about to wrap this up. Oh my god, you have to go with that stupid name! Jesus Christ. Well, I guess that's one way to wrap up this recording session. And we are about done here.
I'm even colder than Snowboard City right now, motherfucker.
Yeah! But with that, we are done here for now. Once we get back to this, we're headed out to the next area, which I believe is Union Cave. That's later. Oh god. But you can probably just DM that to me when we're done here. But yeah, with that, later. But yeah, later.